Hello everyone watching this video on my YouTube channel. A very warm welcome to this web series on thermodynamics. My name is Sanjay Geji, assistant professor at Mechanical Engineering Department, working at Padma Bhushan Vasantrao Dada Patil Institute of Technology, shortly known as PVPIT Budgaon, located at Sangli. Our institute is affiliated to Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar Technological University, DBAT2, Raigad. So let us start today's session of with this web series. So this is the third lecture of this web series. Before proceeding, I would like to give a brief intro of this web series. This web series on thermodynamics is being recorded and published on my YouTube channel. For all mechanical engineers and all others who are really interested in thermodynamics as a free learning resource and reference. The contents and flow of sessions are designed or planned with a practical approach. The theories are well supported by suitable practical examples and applications so that you will have a clear understanding of how to use these theoretical concepts in practice while dealing with or handling the real-time problems and cases. Believe me, although this thermodynamics seems to be more of a theoretical nature, it is very much practical. It is really very much practical if it is applied properly with the clear and sound understanding of concepts, of basics. Okay, so if you learn it this way, it is really a very interesting package. Okay, so the whole purpose and scope of this web series is quite broad and very meaningful in sense. Okay, now for the students of SY BTech Mechanical who are right now studying this year, can access this web series on my YouTube channel very easily and freely, as YouTube is available to all and accessible from anywhere. Particularly the students who cannot attend or miss out the live online classes due to some reasons like poor internet connectivity or some other personal reasons, can cover up for the missed out or lost out parts by watching these videos on this YouTube channel. And they can do it anytime from anywhere, and they can see it multiple times repeatedly. Okay, well, I know that for some students sometimes who are regularly attending the live online classes, but still it is not possible for them to grasp all things or everything of the contents delivered by the teacher at that moment in just one shot or one go. Okay, so such students can watch out for the missed out or skipped out portions of course of a syllabus through this web series. So this web YouTube web series really helps and allows the slow learners and beginners to learn at their own pace or speed and as per their own convenience by watching the videos repeatedly again and again till the point they can understand satisfactorily. Okay, so this way all the students will be at same level in terms of coverage of syllabus and understanding at the end of course or at the end of semester. Okay, so this such a provision of free learning resources levels out the difference between fast learners and average students or weak students also. Okay, also the students of third year or fourth year engineering and passed out ones who are preparing for GATE exams, various competitive exams, or facing the technical job interviews, appearing for technical aptitude tests, etc., can also revisit and revise and get their understanding clear for the important concepts. And even practicing engineers may refer to this YouTube web series as a quick and ready reference or resource to get their doubts cleared and apply those concepts in their practice to enhance their experience further. Okay. Now I would like to have a recap of what was covered during the first two video sessions. In the first video, it was all about the introductory talk on thermodynamics, covering a lot of historical events in the development of thermodynamics and its relation to the Industrial Revolution process, which actually was a very big turnaround and life-changing experience for all of the world. And various stages of industrial revolution, such as generations, industry 1, 2, 3, 4, how that progress happened, all that we saw, and various applications of thermodynamics, which are directly or indirectly are relating to our day-to-day life. Okay, so then we proceeded to second video session. In that, we started off with the preliminary terms of thermodynamics, such as system, thermodynamic surrounding, and system boundary, and various types of systems, and all those theories of these theoretical concepts were well explained with the help of practical examples and applications. So giving a certain perspective to how to use these theories in practice while dealing with real-time problems. Okay. So with this background, let us move to the third video of today, in continuation with the fundamental concepts. So again, I would like to recommend books and references that I had told earlier in the first second video. These are the two textbooks available for covering much of the syllabus, and very good and very easy to understand for majority of students. Okay, covering majority of syllabus, and those who are interested going further and have sound understanding, as a special interest, they can go at some depth. These are the reference books, and they provide or they give some detailed treatment to various thermodynamic concepts as such. Okay, and various complex problems are also discussed at certain depth. Okay, so with this, and one more thing I would like to tell, these books as a PDF or e-copies, you can easily get it from Google. You just Google it, you will find number of resources, free resources to download them as a PDF. Okay, you need not to buy. And just a general note to all, to support your study and for a clear understanding of any subject or such like thermodynamics, you should refer to at least 2 to 3 good books. Okay, so that gives you complete idea, because every author has his own way of explaining things. So you will find that some books are good with some concepts or some points, while some other books are good at the rest of other topics. Okay, so this is how the very different authors will present their matter content. Okay, so this is the outline of this video. We are going to discuss what is the thermodynamic state and properties of system. We will look at dimensions and units. The unit systems, very popular one, are British units and SI units. We will have a review of some basic physical quantities. Okay, now these basic, there are many basic physical quantities. We are not going to discuss all of them. We are only focusing on those which are required on for thermodynamic, for continuation of a thermodynamic study on a regular basis. Every now and then we have to deal with these physical quantities, such as force, weight, density, specific volume, specific gravity, work, energy, and power. Okay, so let's begin now. First one is a thermodynamic state. A state means a specific condition or a status of a system. Now look at this figure. A cylinder containing some gas is provided. and the state is this state is state number one or specific condition is defined by these properties. Mass is 2 kg, temperature T1 is 20 degrees Celsius, volume V1 is 1.5 meter cube. Okay. When the same system changes to some other state due to change in the properties. Okay. So now look at here. Mass remains 2 kg, temperature T2 remains 20 degrees Celsius, but there is change in volume from 1.5 meter cube to 2.5 meter cube. So it makes another set of conditions. So it is defining completely new state, so state 2. So for a single system, there can be n number of such states. Okay. Then next, a thermodynamic property. It is a property is any character or characteristic or attribute of a system which describes the state or the condition of a system. Okay. A property is any characteristic or attribute of a matter or a system which can be evaluated quantitatively, so that you can have some quantitative measure for that. Okay. And these are useful like this. The amount of energy transferred in a given process, such as work done during the process or energy stored in a system, etc., are all evaluated in terms of changes of the system properties. Okay. So if you want to find some energy transfer or work done mechanism, that will be dealt with in the change of system properties, such as there will be change in volume, change in pressure, or change in temperature, and that information will be used to carry out the required analysis. Okay. Then typical thermodynamic properties are pressure, volume, temperature, mass, etc. Okay. One more thing I want to tell you about property. Property is that which specifies a particular condition or a state of a system or state of a body, or it gives a complete description. For example, my name, everyone carries a name, so that name is his property. My name is Sanjay, so Sanjay is my property, which is defining me, so which is defining my identity. Okay. In this way, all in India, all we are having Aadhaar card number. We have been assigned one unique identification number, that is the Aadhaar card number. So Aadhaar card number is a property of everyone, every individual. The same way people have their vehicles, we have our vehicles numbered in different way. Every vehicle is having a different registration number, so that that will be a unique identification for that particular vehicle. Okay, so that is also property. Same in the same way, a PAN card number is also property of every individual. Okay, so in this way, every state of a system will be described by these properties. Okay, this is how we have to correlate the theory and our day-to-day life experiences. Okay, here you can see in this figure, some space is provided and it is having mass M, volume V, temperature T, pressure P, and density rho. Okay, these are typical properties. Now, thermodynamic properties are distinguished into two categories: extensive properties and intensive properties. Now, what are these? Let us look at them. Let us look at the definition. Extensive property depends on how much of the substance is present or the extent of the system under consideration. It depends on the size or mass of the system. Examples are mass, volume, energy, etc. Okay. Then intensive property is independent of the mass of substance or system under consideration, and independent of size or mass or extent of the system. Okay. Examples are temperature, pressure, density. Now, to understand this concept, just look at this figure. Now we were having a single system of these properties: mass M, V, volume V, temperature T, pressure P, density rho. Okay. When this space is divided with some partition in two parts, okay, two half parts, so mass can get easily divided into half, that is half mass here, half mass here. Volume can be easily divided like half volume here, half volume here, just due to physical partition. But the same cannot be said about the temperature, pressure and density, because temperature, a uniform temperature, you can measure here, here, everywhere, at any corner, that will be same. If you put, whether you put a partition or not, it will show the same value. The same way pressure of the gas will be uniform across the space. By just putting the partition, it is not going to change. So temperature, pressure, these are intensive properties which cannot be divided into parts. So it cannot be like let us assign some values here. Temperature, suppose here 20 degrees Celsius. So just by division, it cannot be made into two halves, like 10 degrees Celsius here, 10 degrees Celsius here. It is not going to happen. If pressure P is 2 bar here, it cannot be like 1 bar here and 1 bar here. Cannot be done that way. Okay. This is the same explanation given here. You can read out. All the specific properties, that is property per unit mass, are intensive properties. Such as specific volume, specific energy are the typical examples. Okay. So whenever properties, extensive properties are divided by mass, they convert it into intensive properties. Okay. Then let us have some review of dimension and units. So dimension means a thing which is used to measure, specify or characterize any physical quantity. Okay. And unit means the magnitude assigned to the dimensions. Examples are mass, volume, length, distance, speed. All these are physical quantities, and the dimension physical quantities, and hence the units may be units will be what are the terms of measurement. Like mass is measured in kilograms, that we know, grams and kilograms. So gram and kilogram is a unit. Okay. Distances are measured in centimeter, meter, millimeter. So millimeter, centimeter, all these are, or feet, inches, all these are units. Okay. Then dimensions are divided as primary dimensions and secondary dimensions. So primary dimensions are the fundamental dimensions. Okay. And secondary dimensions are those which are derived from fundamental dimensions, primary dimensions. Let us now look at this. So primary or fundamental dimensions are very few, like mass, length, time, temperature, and so on. Okay. These are typical examples. Then secondary dimensions are the derived from these dimensions. Here you can see the area is always given by product of length into breadth, multiplication of length into breadth. Volume is a product of length, height and breadth. So then speed or velocity is distance over time. So here you can see this L is length, mass M is mass, and time is small, capital T, temperature small t. These dimensions are looking like a combination of these fundamental or primary dimensions. Okay. That's why they are derived from primary dimensions. Then there are unit systems. Okay. There are famously two unit systems in practice. First one is English or British units, and the other one is System International or SI units. Okay. The English or British units, also known as IP, that is inch and pound unit system, these are mostly used in UK and United States of America. This is one of the oldest oldest unit system, which was developed by British people. Okay. It happened so because and it got popularized, and it was spread across widely at various places. This is because most of the development or scientific exploration was happening in Britain in around the 16th or 17th century, and they were blessed with having the scientists like Isaac Newton, James Watt, James Joule, Robert Stirling, Lord Kelvin. All those were British people, originated from England. Okay. So the initial development began with England or British. So they formed their own system. So that was, and they were having, so they were using their own dimensions and units. Okay, and most of the parts, and at that time for many centuries, British were like empire or largest empire on the earth, and they were ruling many of the territories, many of the countries. Just we India were also under the British rule for most of 150 years or so. Okay, after 150 years, then we got independence just in 1947. Okay, so still their influence is there. Okay, particularly in India, we find that most of the units we follow in British system. For example, because we were under British influence for most of the part, and our education system, the setups of industries, commercial things were initiated by under the influence of British people. So and we also our generation also got brought up while dealing with these units. That's why we most of the time we find that lengths are specified in feet and inches. Okay, whenever you ask for your height, you say my height is 5 feet and 6 inch. Okay, or when we are talking about area or some space, that will be specified in square feet area. Okay, so we are well familiar with it, and we are very comfortable with these British units. Okay, so this is how the units are units in which quantities are measured. Volume is measured in cubic feet or gallons. Time, again, minute, 60 seconds. Mass are measured in pounds. Okay. Then the next one is SI units. It is of a modern nature, and it is recently developed. Okay. Also known as System International or Metric Units. Nowadays, our study also is being done through SI units. Okay, because most of the countries across India, across the world, apart from UK and USA, have agreed and have accepted this unit system on international level, so that some uniformity, interchangeability and standard can be maintained. Okay, for the ease of international trade and import and export businesses and various exchanges of materials. Okay, so this has been a practice, and we India, in India, we are also moving from British system to SI unit system. But still, when you go to marketplace, you will still struggle, or you will find it hard to deal with the SI units. For example, if you go to purchase a pipe, the seller asks you to specify diameter in inches, like half inch diameter or 2 inch diameter or 1/4 inch diameter. So in that way, you have to specify. If you say 10 millimeter diameter pipe or 20 millimeter diameter pipe, it is not so convenient, okay, for the people. Then these are the fundamental units for the fundamental dimensions. Mass is measured in kilogram, length is measured in meters, time is measured in seconds, and so on. Okay, temperature is measured in Kelvin or degrees Celsius. Then there are some multipliers and prefixes that we have to use according to convenience, according to the values in practice. Okay, for example, SI unit of distance is meter, but suppose we are specifying, or we are saying the distance between two cities like Sangli and Kolhapur, we know it is 50 kilometers. So it is very convenient to use a bigger unit, because distance is very large. If we say it is 50,000 meters, it becomes very uncomfortable or inconvenient in practice to say like that, and we will not have a proper feel for that, a proper understanding of that. So for larger values of quantities, there are these prefixes, such as kilo means 10 raised to 3, mega means 10 raised to 6, giga means 10 raised to 9, and tera means 10 raised to 12. In the same way, we have prefixes and units for smaller values, such as thickness of various plates or various materials are specified in millimeters or centimeters, because thickness is very small as compared to 1 meter. So on low side it goes like milli 10 raised to minus 3, centi 10 raised to minus 2, micro 10 raised to minus 6, nano 10 raised to minus 9, pico 10 raised to minus 12. So all these values and multipliers we have to use every now and then. Okay. So this is some conversion chart between SI unit and British units. We have to deal with it. We have to use such conversion factors whenever the data is not available in SI units. Okay. So we have to use these conversion factors. These are readily available from any engineering data book, or you can get it from internet also. Okay. Then let us now review some physical quantities. Okay. So first one is force. A force is a physical quantity that has come out from Newton's second law of motion, that we all know. So force is given by mass into acceleration, m into a. Now SI unit of force is 1 newton. It is named after Isaac Newton, the great scientist who discovered the theory of gravity and proposed the Newton's law, his laws of motions, known as famously known as Newton's laws of motion. Okay, so 1 newton force is defined as force required to accelerate a mass of 1 kg at a rate of 1 meter per second square. Okay, so this is a mass of 1 kg. A force is, I suppose, force F is acting and it is accelerating it at 1 meter per second square. So that force will be said 1 newton. Okay. Then weight. Many times weight and mass are considered or confused with the as same things in general sense, because in general talk, when somebody asks you weight, you say it is simply kg. Somebody is weighing, suppose, 60 kg. Okay, but the weight we specify in kg, but we know that kg is the unit of mass, purely mass. Okay. But weight is a gravitational force applied to body by the planet Earth. The gravitational force always directs towards the center of the planet, and on ground surface it appears to be a vertically downwards. Okay, and so basically weight is a force of gravity given by m into g, mass into acceleration due to gravity, and this g value is 9.81 meter per second square as a universal standard. Okay. See, mass remains constant irrespective of any scenario. But weight changes with respect to gravity. So weight will be different on different planets. On Earth it will be different because of different acceleration due to gravity. If the same mass is taken to the some other planet like Mars or Moon, you will find a change in its weight because of change in gravity. Okay, for example, suppose this lady is taken to the moon, and if she is standing on the weighing machine there, her weight of 66 kg on the Earth, it will on the moon it will show only 11 kg. Okay, because the acceleration due to gravity is 1/6, is very less. It is 1/6 of the gravity on Earth's surface. Okay, so this is how. The weight and mass, we have to understand difference between weight and mass. Okay. Then next is density and specific volume. Density defined as mass per unit volume, rho given by mass upon volume, units SI unit, kg per meter cube. Specific volume is a reciprocal of density. It is defined as volume per unit mass, small v equal to v upon m equal to 1 upon rho meter cube per kg SI units. Okay, small examples shown here. Small volume V 12 meter cube, mass 3 kg. So density rho equal to 0.25 kg per meter cube by dividing mass of 3 kg by volume 3/12, and specific volume reciprocal of density, that is 4 meter cube per kg, 1 divided by 0.25. Okay, in thermodynamics we will be requiring this term, specific volume, on a regular basis. Okay. Now see, density of any substance in general depends on temperature and pressure. For solids and liquids, density depends more strongly on temperature than on pressure, because they are incompressible in nature. So the change in volume is very less with change in pressure. That's why density is mostly independent of pressure. But for gases, being compressible, change in volume is quite big with change in pressure. Okay, so density of most gases is directly proportional to pressure and inversely proportional to temperature. Okay. Let us have a look at some typical values of some common fluids or common materials, and these are treated as a universal standards or universal values, and one should remember these values. Sometimes in problem solving, data is not given, so we have to assume these values, and you are expected to know these values. Okay. So at 20 degrees Celsius, 1 atmospheric pressure surrounding conditions, water density is 1000 kg per meter cube. It is in liquid at ambient conditions. Petrol density is 700 kg per meter cube. It remains as a liquid at ambient conditions. Density for air is 1.2 kg per meter cube, which is in a gas phase at ambient conditions. Mercury density is 13,600 kg per meter cube. It is a liquid metal. It is the only metal which maintains its liquid state at ambient conditions. Steel and gold are the metals which remain in solid state at ambient conditions. So steel is 7,800 kg per meter cube and gold 19,600 kg per meter cube. By these values, you can imagine how heavy is the gold due to its higher density. Okay. Specific gravity is the next term. Sometimes it is convenient to specify the density of substance relative terms, that is relative to density of a well-known and standard substance, and this term is known as specific gravity or relative density. So it is defined as a ratio of a density of a substance, of any substance, to the density of standard substance at a specified temperature. Generally, water is taken as a standard substance for most of the liquids and solids. So rho taken as 1000 kg per meter cube, and for I have not mentioned here, but note that air is taken as a standard substance for dealing with gases. So specific gravity capital S equal to rho divided by density of water, rho water. Since it is a ratio, it is a dimensionless quantity or unitless quantity. Okay. So these are some specific gravities of commonly found materials. Let us look at here what is the implication of value of S. So specific gravity being a ratio, it may be equal to 1, it may be less than 1, or it may be greater than 1. So what it means? When S is less than 1, substances are lighter than water, hence they will float on the water. When specific gravity is less than 1, so those materials will be less denser as compared to water. Examples are plastic, wood, petrol, oil. All these objects will float. You will find them floating when you put them onto in the water. Okay, and there are some substances having specific gravity more than 1. Such substances are heavier in nature than heavier than the water, having more density. So when you put these objects in water, they will sink down to bottom. Okay. Examples: stones and various metals like steel, gold, copper, etc. Okay. So from this, you can get the understanding of specific gravity and heaviness or lightness of materials. Okay, for example, gasoline 0.7 less than 1, so it will float on water. For wood 0.3 to 0.9. okay, lighter than water. Mercury it is 13.6, so, and gold it is 19.2. So it is mercury 13.6 times heavier than water. Okay, so this is how it works. Next concept is work. In mechanics, when a force F is acting on a body of mass m, displaces it through a distance s in the direction of force, this action is known as work done on the body by the force F. Okay, now see this diagram. So there is a mass m of a body, and it is being pulled by this force F in this direction, and it is this force is causing a displacement of this body from this point to this point through displacement s. Okay, so this action is known as a work is done on this this object. Okay, so it is given by product of force into displacement, W equal to force into displacement. So SI unit will be Newton meter. Force unit is Newton, distance unit is meter, so Newton meter. Okay, now see, if the force F is not constant, sometimes it is not constant, then work done will be given by integrating or adding the differential amounts of work. So in differential form you will find W equal to integral 1 to 2 del W. This is a differential amount of work applied over the integral from 1 to 2, that is from position 1 to position 2. So from 1 to 2, integral 1 to 2 FDS, Newton meter. Okay, work is one of the modes of energy transfer. Okay, the next concept is energy. It is defined as a capacity to do work or capacity to cause the change. Okay, now we saw how the displacement takes place, how the mechanical work is performed. It is performed by force. Just look at this again. So work of displacement is performed by force F. So okay, now who is providing this force? What is that agency that provides the force? Okay, that agency will be known as energy. This force comes out of energy. Okay, so energy exists in various forms, such as mechanical, thermal, electrical, chemical, magnetic, nuclear, solar, etc. Okay, many of the engineering process involves energy conversion from one form to another form, or it will be a transfer of energy from one place to another place, or it will be energy storage in various forms. So this is how we have to deal with energy as a physical quantity. Okay, since the work is one of the modes of energy transfer, both energy and work are equivalent quantities. Okay, here we saw this is the work due to force, this is the effect of force on this effect of displacement of force F on this body. So this work is being done out of energy. Okay, so both are equivalent terms. Okay, so SI unit for energy is joule. Again, it is named after a great scientist, James Joule, who contributed a lot to the development of first law of thermodynamics with his extensive amount of research work and experimentation. So 1 joule equal to 1 Newton meter. Okay, both are equivalent. Next term is power. Power is defined as a rate of energy transfer or energy storage or rate of doing work. Okay, so it will be a rate of energy transfer or it will be a rate of doing mechanical work. Okay, so power means energy per unit time. So power E dot equal to total energy E divided by time T. Okay, when content of total content of energy is divided by time T, it becomes a quantity. Okay, a dot is provided to indicate it is a rate. It is rate means per unit time. Quantities per unit time are known as rate. Okay, it is okay. In cricketing terms, I would like to take example. Number of runs scored is like a energy. Total number of runs scored is like a energy. Suppose 100 runs scored are 100. This is the energy. Okay, and run rate will be runs scored per over. Runs scored per over. So run rate will be the rate at which runs are scored, the rate at which those 100 runs are scored. Okay, so suppose those 100 runs are scored in 10 overs. So run rate will be 100 divided by 10, number of overs. So it is, run rate is 10. Okay, But if the same amount of runs are scored in 20 overs, so 10, 100 divided by 20, 100 divided by 20, it makes as a run rate as a 5 runs per over. Okay, in the first case, run rate is 10 runs per over. The next, in the second case, run rate is 5 runs per over. So it indicates the speed. It indicates the speed at which, how slow or how fast the energy is being transferred. Okay, so that is why power is very important term. So SI unit of power is watt. Again, it is named after a great scientist and engineer, James Watt, who actually developed the steam engines and for their better performance and made them commercial success, leading up to industrial revolution process, and rest is the history. Okay, major units used in practice are kilowatt, megawatt, gigawatt, etc. Okay, the 1 watt is defined like this: 1 joule divided by 1 second. 1 joule per second is equal to 1 watt. Okay, so with this, this is the end of this third video. I hope you enjoyed all the contents of today's session, and we will be continuing further in this fashion. If you haven't yet subscribed my YouTube channel, so please subscribe it and press the bell icon to receive the notifications of latest updates from me. And if you have any doubts, any questions in your mind, if you want to give feedback about the total quality of this videos in terms of audio or video, or you want something to be added to it for further enhancement and further improvement, you are free to tell. Your inputs will be very welcome, and I will try to inculcate or try to implement all those the feedbacks received by you. Okay, if you want me to make any particular video on any particular some other topic related to thermodynamics or related to engineering, you can put your demand there in the comment box. I will definitely try to address. Okay, and again, if you like this video, please press the like button also, and you like the content, please share it with your friends and families and colleagues to various WhatsApp groups. You can share the link. Okay, this is my WhatsApp number and email ID. You can communicate to me or contact me anytime. Okay, thank you. Have a nice day. Stay fit, stay healthy. See you again in the next video. Thank you very much.